is the performer. Tentatively it can beat, and this is Dick Turner. So I'm going to read an excerpt from my review of Joan Kaiser's Boulez, composer, conductor, enigma. Boulez is definitely attached to being the maestro of the hierarchy. At least he worked hard for it. Obviously, so inspired by Mallarmé's La Libre, Boulez attempted, in his own words, to break completely the closed form. He refused to share the responsibility with the rest of us. In a 1964 interview in The Times, Boulez deprecated the performer's ability to work in the creative process. I have no confidence in the imagination of performers, he said. A performer's head is full of formulas, drawn and musically played. If he had the necessary attention, he would be a composer himself. That's from page 162. So, what about the performers who are also composers? For example, trombonist composer Vinko Globo. Refer to his record of Deutsche Grammophon's Avant-Garde in Brit, in which he performs his own Discord de or Saint Trombone, 1967-68, and a work by Berio and a work by Stockhausen. Performance of Stockhausen's Aufwand, and Stockhausen was against this. So Globocard shows the record as anonyme. I have mixed feelings about this. On the one hand, I think the composer deserves credit for initiating the process. I think the performers, depending upon the degree of their creative input, which is considerable in the case of Alphonse, deserves to be given substantial credit too. Hence my preference for the term realization rather than just performance, in the case of works where the performers are major contributors. What about Stockhausen? Stockhausen dropped his ties to structure and God at the same time. He left his wife and their four children and married a painter and produced more progeny. He built a splendid house in the suburbs alone and expected both women and all the children to live with it. Ignoring the practical megalomania of expecting everyone to live together as one big happy family, I have to wonder if he built a splendid house, part of the above. Maybe he built it, but it seems more like a natural development. And maybe someone else could build it for him. Rich people have tended to take credit for things that they pay other people to do for them. I hate that. I especially hate it when it's something created. I call the results employer art. The attitude of rich people often seems to be that people that actually do physical things are beneath notice. Certainly beneath any credit. I could say more, much more, but I'll move on.
Thank you. Ha ha ha.